Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Coding Card. So in this session we'll try to solve one HackerRank problem. So you can see here the problem is matrix script and it's under regular expression and parsing, and you can see here the difficulty level is hard. So let me first explain you this problem here. Here the problem states that new has a complex matrix script. The matrix script is of n cross m grid of strings. It consists of alphanumeric characters, space and these symbols. So we will be given a matrix script. We have to decode this given matrix script, and for the decoding there are certain rules, and the rule is to decode the script, Neo needs to read each column and select only the alphanumeric character and connect them. Neo reads the column from top to bottom and start reading from the leftmost column, from top to bottom and from the leftmost column, means from here. So if there are symbols or a space between two alphanumeric characters of the decoded script, then Neo replaces them with a single space for better readability. So for example, you can see here, this is my decoded script. So you can see here between S and I, there are certain symbols, dollar and hash. So we have to replace this dollar with single space and again hash with single space. And Neo feels that there is no need of use of if condition, so we don't have to use if condition, and alphanumeric character consists of this a to z and a small a to z and 0 to 9, and the input format is the very first line consists of integer n rows and m columns, and the second line is the elements for the matrix script. So you can see here, this is my sample input which consists of 7 rows and 3 columns. And you can see here the sample output. So this is my sample output. So before this, we have to decode the given matrix. So you can see here, this is the decoded one, where dollar n has again this percentage space. These things are present between the alphanumeric characters. So we have to replace these symbols with a single space. So after replacing this with a single space, you can see here, this is a space after replacing this one. So you can see here, this is matrix. So we have to replace only between the alphanumeric characters. So only up to this much. So after replacing, you can see here, we can read, this is matrix. So that's why they have mentioned for better readability, we have to replace these symbols with a single space for better readability. So you can see here, you can simply read this one, this is a matrix. So we have to write the code for this one. So let me first explain you this in a simple way. Suppose this is my list. So we will be given a list. So 7 rows, this is my 7 rows and 3 columns. So these are 3 columns, and we have to read from top to bottom and from the leftmost from here. So there are 7 lists. So if I simply use a gif function, for this one, so before this gif function, you can see here what is the decoded one, decoded string. So let me write that one, the decoded one. The decoded one is this dollar has is percentage space matrix has space credit dollar and not dollar percentage and not. So this is my decoded string. So to get this decoded string, we have to apply few formula and logic here. So if I start reading from here, so you can see here, if I crack this one like this, so you can see here, if I am going like this one in this format, this, you can see here, this, I am done here, this. Again, you can see here, if I again go here from up to down, and again this one, if I combine these things, so this is my x1, this is my x2, and this is my x3. So I will be getting x1, x2, and x3. This will be a tuple. Now, if I simply convert this x1, x2 as s1, s2, and s3, and simply add these 3 string, you will be getting this decoded string. So to get this three tuple, I will simply use a zip function on this given list. Suppose this is a list of list, I will simply use a zip function on, suppose this is my list L. So I will simply use a zip function on this L to get this, and after that we'll simply apply a logic to get this into a string format, and after that we'll simply apply a regular expression. Let us try to understand line by line in the code. Suppose the very first is the sample input for N and M. So let me take here, let me explain you here. The very first thing is N and M. Suppose I'm taking N and M, N comma M equal to, I have to take this in an integer type. So for that we'll simply use a map int comma input dot split. Now we are done with the very first line, N and M. Now the very first thing is here, taking the input for N and M. After that we have to take the elements of the matrix, which is 7 list. So for means n list, with this is my n value. So for that I will simply use a for loop. So for that let me first take a list, L equal to list type, where I will be appending all the input elements. So for that let me take for loop for I in range of n. Now I will be appending all the input in the list, L dot append of all the input. So for the very first iteration, this will be taken in a single list, again this one in a single list, as you can see here, this one as a single list. Again, for the second iteration, this will be in a single list, again this one, and similarly for the rest. So we are done with the list. So let us print here, let us check whether it is working or not. Print L. Now we'll simply apply a zip function to get the result. We'll simply apply a zip function to get this result, this x1, x2 and x3. So let me apply a zip function for the given list, and we'll simply convert this into a list type, and let me store this in a, again in list L. We print and see whether it is working or not. Now we are done with the input, so let us execute this one and see whether it is working or not. So the very first is 7 and 3. Now we have to take the sample input. The very first was T S I, second is H percentage X, third is I space has, after that M S M and space, after that we have dollar A space, again has TN percentage, after that IR and not. So now you can see here, this is the very first list, this is the very first list, it is working. And the second one is the x1, x2 and x3 value. So this is my x1, THIS, here I have taken I in a capital, no problem. And this is x1, this is my x2, you can see here, and this is my x3. So you can see here x1 is THIS dollar has and I. So you can see here x1 is THIS dollar has and I, and x2 is the second column and x3 is the third column. So now we are done with the this one. Now our task is to convert this into a string. So for that let me take a empty string. Now we'll simply join this one. So for that for I in this final list, for I in L, we'll simply add this to get a single string. S equal to S plus, simply add this one dot join all the values x1. For the very first iteration, it will add all the character of this x1. For the second iteration, it will add the character of the x2, and for the third, it will add this x3, and the result will be stored in S. So let us print and see whether it is working or not. Print S. Now let me execute this one and see. So let me instead of here, let me execute here. Let's see. Otherwise, I have to again take the all the sample input. Now let me execute and see. So now you can see here we have got the decoded string. Now our third task is to remove these characters symbols between two alphanumeric characters. So for this we'll simply use a regular expression. For that, let me import re, and we'll simply apply the logic. Suppose this is my string S. So we'll simply apply a logic. Suppose, let me erase this one. Suppose this is my decoded string. Now if I simply apply a logic, I have to just remove the symbols between the alphanumeric characters. So from here to here, I have my alphanumeric characters. I'll write a regular expression such that if any symbols other than alphanumeric character are present, like this one, again this space, we'll simply replace with a single space. So let me first write a logic such that it works in a boundary form. Means I have to take the word between the boundary. Means I have to apply a word boundary from here to here. So let me write the regular expression. So I'll be saving that the final result in S only. So for that, I'll simply apply a regular expression re dot sub. Now I have to take the boundary, and the boundary condition is, suppose from b2 slash b, I have to take the condition between this one, and I will be replacing with r of space, single space, and I will pass this simple the resultant string here s1, and I am passing this string, and I am also saving in the string S only, the final string. Now I have to write my logic here between these two boundary, word boundary here. So for that, let me take all the alphanumeric character from A to Z, capital A to capital Z, and from 0 to 9. Now if they are present single or multiple, I have to take their non-presence. If any character other than alphanumeric characters, means we have to ignore the alphanumeric characters. If any other alphanumeric characters are, not alphanumeric, if any other characters other than alphanumeric characters are present, either their occurrence is one or many, we have to simply replace with the space. Now let us print this S and C. So you can see here it has worked between the two boundary case. It has simply replaced with the single space. So now it is working. So let us try to write in a single here, single line, means single consolidated one. So I simply copy and paste here. Copy this one. Paste here. We have checked line by line whether it is working or not. So our logic is working and we'll simply copy and paste here. So we have to import, we have to write this import statement above. The very first line. Let us take this one. Paste here. Now we have to remove this print statement. That was for our own checking condition that it is working or not. So at last we have to print the answer. So this print is okay. So let us try to run this for the given sample input against the custom input. Let us copy and paste here and run this code. So you can see here it is working fine. So let me run and submit this code. So you can see here it is working fine for the given sample input test case. Let me submit this code. So we have passed almost all the test cases. So congratulations, we are done with the hidden test cases. So this was the simple logic. We have to first use the GIF function and again we have to convert this into a string, and after that we have to apply a regular expression between the two boundaries of the alphanumeric characters, this one. So if you like this video, please do give thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for the next problem. Thanks for watching.